welcome. I'm the Economics Dude, back from my vacation to give you the top 10 tips for economics students. Today, these will be more common sense ideas for students, but these are very valuable tips to help you pass your exam if you're currently studying economics in the bachelor's or master's level. So let's begin with tip number 10. Tip number 10, read the questions carefully. This is very common sense, but it's very surprising how many students actually fail to follow this tip. Because if the question asks you, for example, to talk about a fiscal shift, and you start talking about a monetary shift, not only do you get no points for that question, but also you run out of time for all the other questions. Tip number 9, label your diagrams. This is another very important point that many students seem to get wrong during their exams. And this could actually subtract half a mark to a mark on your question, which could be the difference between an A, a B, or a C. So for example, say we wanted to know which way demand would shift. Say we have demand shifting upwards from D0 to D1. This is not enough to achieve full marks if you're asked to illustrate your example. What you must do for a traditional supply and demand diagram is to label price and then label quantity demanded. This will give you full marks in the exam if you're asked to illustrate. Tip number 8, eat before your exam. This is not a very economic tip, but you'll definitely find that in a 3-hour exam, you need all the energy you can get. For the night before, I suggest a food like tuna or salmon. To me, that is definitely my brain food before any other exam or important presentation. Tip number 6, show all calculations. If you're given a mathematical example asking you to, for example, find a given quantity and then a given price for company 1 and company 2, and you simply write down what the final answer is, and it's wrong, you will get no points for the question. But if you show how you worked it out, and it's the right method, then you at least get a little bit from it. Tip number five, lecture notes are not enough. If you simply go to a lecture and take down what was said during the lecture, that is enough for a very basic answer for most of the questions. But if you want to be assured of getting an A or a B, you must also use what has been given to you within the textbooks and also within any seminar classes. And that will help you achieve the higher marks. Tip number 4, at the end, reread your exam. It is very common for students to misinterpret a question or to miss a certain value for a calculation question. This could mean precious points lost and you have gone down a grade when you shouldn't have. Tip number 3, at the very start of the exam, plan. Plan exactly how you're going to tackle each one of the questions and what is required of you. This will help that you do not stress out during the exam and it helps to further time management. Tip number 2, follow economic principles. And by this I mean, don't assume that everything that is going to be said on the exam will be a trick question. Questions might be phrased a bit odd to make you think about what the question could be, but it's not going to rewrite most of the common economic laws, especially at the bachelor's level. For example, if a question does not ask you to explain a special case, then use common sense and exactly read what the question really has to say, because every mark counts. For example, if you were to draw a upward sloping demand curve, this is an extremely, extremely rare case that would almost never happen. And so drawing this would lead to probably serious depression for most of the economics professors who would have to mark your exam.
It's just not fair.
So starting off, tip number 1, List all important points in the margin. This is especially important if you have a calculation question with a big lines of text that give you many values that you have to plug into an economic equation. Pick out what are the most important values that you must put in your equation on the very side of the page. For example, what is given quantity and given prices and given interest rates and so on. This will help you to not miss key points in your calculation questions or in any other word-based questions that you might have. So thanks for listening. And until next time, I'm the Economics Dude. You've been awesome. See ya.